There is even a slot for a mini wind vane for the traveller to see in which direction the wind might take them next. Copernicus. Copernican revolution led to a new model of the universe which placed the sun, rather than the earth, at the centre of the solar system. The revolution began with the publication of mathematician and astronomer Nicholas Copernicus's De Revolutionibus Orbium Coelestium, 1543. By the 16th century, moreover, a crucial change had occurred in the understanding that lay behind the shadow clock. For millennia, the movement of the shadow around the face of the dial was understood to reflect the movement of the Earth as the centre of the universe around the sun. This all began to change in 1514 with Nicholas Copernicus's work Commentariolus and his subsequent 1543 work De Revolutionibus, which demonstrated that the opposite was true, that the Earth in fact orbited the sun. His ideas were followed up by a handful of history's most eminent astronomers. The Danish scholar Tycho Brahe, 1546-1601, who significantly improved the observational data upon which Copernicus had based his theory, though he disagreed with Copernicus on a number of factors. The Italian Galileo Galilei, 1564-1642, who, with the use of the newly invented telescope, observed that Venus also orbited the sun, strengthening the Copernican explanation. And Isaac Newton, 1642-1726, who explained the physics of orbiting bodies in terms of gravitational attraction. Snug in the history of the shadow, therefore, lies evidence that the brightest stars in our scholarly history spent significant time on this specific type of shadow, and in so doing discovered and then explained that the Earth orbited the sun, which is nothing less than the key to understanding our universe and is one of the most important scientific breakthroughs ever made.